What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the RealMines Minecraft plugin. Obviously, collecting resources is a big part of the Minecraft game, and depending on your setup, it can get pretty difficult for your players to find the things they need. If you're wanting to make it easier for all players to gather materials and blocks, then try out the RealMines plugin. This gives you the ability to create mining areas in the world, allowing users to gather resources. Whether you want diamond ores or wood logs inside of this mine, you have endless possibilities, so let's go over how to do it. To start the download process, head to the RealMines page on Spigot and press Download Now in the top right corner. Save this file somewhere easily accessible on your computer, and then do the same thing for the World Edit Dependency plugin. Now, before starting the server install, make sure you're running a plugin-compatible server like Purpur or Spigot. After that, stop the server and click FTP File Access near the top left, log in, and then find and enter the Plugins folder. Press Upload in the top left corner, and on the next page, drag your files into the upload area. And once this reaches 100%, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel and restart the server. Before joining the server, you'll also want to become a server operator. This is needed to give yourself access to RealMines, as most of its features are for administrators and owners. Alternatively, you can assign permissions to your account or group to achieve the same result. The first step towards making your new mine is finding the right place for it in your world. This might involve entering creative mode and building an area, but it can also be an area you come across. Once you've determined a suitable spot for the mine, type wand to obtain the world edit tool. Afterwards, left-click one of the top corner blocks of your mining area, and then right-click the opposite one at the bottom level. Once you've done this, two chat messages will appear confirming these positions. Once you've determined the positions of your area, it's time to create the mine. This is done by executing mine create name in chat with anything you want in the name field. After running this command, a menu will appear offering you two options. Most server owners will want to choose the blocks one, since the other requires an external schematic file. Immediately after selecting this option, you'll be prompted to confirm the creation by typing yes or no in the game's chat. RealMines allows you to completely customize the mine without needing to edit any configuration file, making it extremely easy to make changes. This is achieved by using the mine panel command, allowing you to select your previously created mine to reveal its options. There's a lot of them to review, such as the ability to rename the mining area, change its name, or alter the reset timer. We suggest changing the mine's icon to another block, since it can get confusing if you have multiple mines with the same logo. Most server owners will want to change the mine's blocks, since by default there's only stone, grass, and dirt available. To do this, select the blocks category while in the main menu. Afterwards, you can click on any current block to change its spawning percentage in the mine, keeping in mind that the percentages do have to add up to 100% and nothing more. If you're wanting to remove anything, then hover over it and press Q on the keyboard. As for adding any new blocks to the mine, click the hopper at the top to reveal the options. Navigating through them requires you to press on the glass to the right and left of the menu. Once you've found your desired blocks, click on it. After doing this, it'll return you back to the main area so you can assign the percentages. When you're all finished with everything, it'll be a wonderful area for players to begin gathering materials. Whether you designed it for ores or for nether resources, there are tons of mines to create in Minecraft. Now, if you're wanting to add even more details for players to admire, there are a few more features in RealMines that you can try out. The first feature to review is the ability to create informative signs, helping players understand how many blocks are left or how many have been destroyed. This plays a crucial role in knowing when a mine resets, since you can configure it to do so when everything runs out. The signs format requires you to type RealMines on the first line, your mine's name on the second, and then a specific setting on the third. Here is a list of these settings that are available to use. Like I said, this plugin is primarily used for operators rather than normal players. However, if you're wanting to assign permission nodes to them so RealMines features become available to a select few, you can use a permissions plugin like LuckPerms to do that. As for making changes to configuration files of RealMines, this is done by accessing them in the FTP. These are called config, language, and mines. Editing the first two is straightforward since it mainly requires you to alter text within quotation marks, but the last one is a bit more technical, mainly requiring value changes to be made. Head to the FTP file access and log in, and then head to the plugins and RealMines directory. Once you're there, press edit on one of the files to reveal the contents, make any desired changes, and then click save at the top, and return to the main panel to restart the server and apply the edits. Before we get into the common issues, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. If you try to create a mine and it fails, make sure you're selecting with the wand tool. This is required for you to choose two block positions for the mining area. After doing this, you need to choose the blocks category once prompted, and once you do that, remember to type either yes or no in chat. If you're looking for a way to help out your players with finding some easy blocks, or if you're looking to spoil them with nether resources, it's all possible with the RealMines plugin. The level of creation is unmatched, and with all of the options to edit, you'll never run out of ways to use it.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.